What's the best kind of chassis suspension joint technology? Well, it depends. All chassis suspension joints have one thing in common. They wear out eventually and need to be replaced. Ball joints, tie rods ends, and stabilizer links take a lot of abuse. However, it's not always obvious how to choose the right replacement part because there are two different types of ball and socket joint technologies in the automotive aftermarket. The first design is what's called greasable or metal on metal because they use centered metal bearings. These designs are common in older passenger vehicles and deliver high rotational torque. To function properly, they need a layer of grease between the ball and socket and can be serviced periodically with fresh grease. This grease not only lubricates the ball and socket, but also helps flush out contaminants and metal particles that have been worn off from friction. The second design is sealed, also known as Lube for Life, which uses an advanced low-friction design. Instead of metal bearings, they use polished ball studs and synthetic polymer bearings. This technology produces a long list of benefits. It causes less internal friction, which makes steering easier. It reduces memory steer, which is when a vehicle continues to pull in the direction of a turn, making steering safer and more precise. It reduces noise vibration and harshness, making rides more comfortable. And because they're sealed, they're maintenance-free. All these reasons are why this type of joint is used as the original equipment on most, if not all, passenger cars today, as well as many light trucks. But you can't simply say that one is better than the other. When choosing between the two technologies, it all depends on how you plan to use and maintain them. Traditionally, regular chassis lubrication would happen with every oil change service or every 3,000 miles, which gave us the term oil and lube. However, service intervals have been steadily increasing, reducing the frequency of lubrication. Some vehicles can now go up to 15,000 miles before a scheduled oil change. This means chassis lubrication no longer happens regularly either, meaning parts may degrade due to excessive friction and need to be replaced. Lack of maintenance and lubrication can lead to degradation, end play, and failure. This doesn't mean a metal-on-metal design is bad. It's still a proven recommended technology for heavy-duty and fleet applications where the suspension joints are being serviced more regularly. However, for more modern, everyday vehicles with extended service intervals, advanced low-friction suspension joints are the ideal way to replace worn-out parts while still maintaining the original manufacturer feel. So, when selecting an aftermarket chassis technology, it's crucial to consider how the vehicle will be used. If the answer is to push, pull, or carry more than it was designed to do, then metal-on-metal is the best design, like in Dorman's premium RD rugged design chassis parts. If the vehicle will be used as intended, then the same advanced low-friction technology that originally came with the car is the best design, such as Dorman's premium extended life chassis parts. To learn more about getting the right chassis parts for the right application, visit dormanproducts.com/chassis.